Microsoft has announced big improvements to Xbox Cloud Gaming when it comes to iPad and iPhone on Safari browser, so let's take a look. What's up, Cloud Gamers? Welcome back to the Cloud Gaming Extreme channel, your destination for all things cloud gaming. And indeed, Microsoft has announced improvements to the Xbox Cloud Gaming experience on your iPad and iPhone through Safari. And this is great because prior to this, I will be completely honest, xCloud has been completely unplayable for me on iPhone or iPad. So let's go ahead and jump into some games, starting with iPad, and see what we have. Now, the first game is one of the newest additions to Game Pass and xCloud, and that's Guardians of the Galaxy, a game that I really enjoyed beating on PC and am only just now jumping into on Xbox thanks to Game Pass and xCloud. Now, prior to the improvements made to iPad and iPhone, I would never have been able to play this game on xCloud as it was just a horrible experience for me. But looking at it now, even though we're just using screen capture on the iPad and it may not fully show you just how good this looks to me in person, it is just a dramatic improvement over what they were offering before, between pixelation and latency and just the lack of disconnects compared to what I had before. Moving over to Gears of War 5, another game that I could hardly ever play. The pixelation, latency, and disconnects in this game as well were horrible for me. It played excellent on the PC app and in browser on PC. It played just fine on my Shield TV with the side-loaded xCloud app, but when it came to my iPhone and iPad, I could not boot this game up and play it. Sometimes it wouldn't launch at all, and sometimes the experience was just so horrible, you couldn't play. But looking at it here on the iPad, it is so much improved, and I really enjoyed my time with Gears 5 here. I played xCloud for about 6 hours after the improvements to test everything out. And when it came to combat and latency, no matter what game I was checking out, it was just much improved over what it was. Not near as much trouble trying to aim for headshots or not having the floaty controls where I'm just kind of all over the screen. It was just a completely different experience from what I was having just a few days ago prior to making this video as I continued to try xCloud. Going over to Halo Infinite, another game that I absolutely had to check out and see how this was doing. Again, another game I could not play on my iPad or iPhone, and this was pretty clean. The pixelation issues were much cleaned up in this for Halo, and combat was no problem either. Now, I tried this on my iPhone as well, and we'll take a look at that, but this was great on my iPad. I could definitely get into Halo Infinite, Guardians, Gears 5, whatever I wanted, and things were just much better. And that's not to say every game is better. There were some games that still suffered some issues, like Doom, Lawnmower Simulator, and others that I tried out and haven't shown in this video were still a bit more pixelated, but with that said, the input latency and lack of disconnects was improved. Now over to one of my favorite experiences on the iPad since trying these improvements, and that's Microsoft Flight Simulator, one of the most gorgeous games made to date. I absolutely love this game, and seeing how clean and how great it ran here on xCloud for me on my iPad was really exciting. This is a game I'll definitely be able to jump into and enjoy from time to time and not have to worry about streaming from my console. I put about an hour into this game in testing. I just got stuck into it again while playing, and it was gorgeous. I never disconnected, it never lost the clean picture, and it was a great experience. Definitely one of my favorites when it came to testing on the iPad. So let's go ahead and jump over to some of these games on the iPhone and see if those improvements carry over.
Bumper one, done.
And indeed, there was a huge improvement when it came to playing on my iPhone, and this is an iPhone 12 Pro, and it's using a Backbone controller, which is one of my favorite controllers if I'm gaming on a phone. Now, you guys know me, I don't really like gaming on a phone, no matter what the case, mobile, cloud, or whatever, but I will say, the experience is so much more improved that input latency, pixelation, lack of disconnects, everything that I suffered for so long on the iPhone and iPad, I kind of expected to carry over, even though the iPad was working so well, but when I fired these games up on my iPhone, I was pleasantly surprised to see that while the quality isn't quite as good as my iPad, it's extremely good and much more playable than it ever was before. Let's go over and take a look at Gears 5. And with Gears 5, the situation remains really good for xCloud. Again, this game was something that there's no chance I could have played on my iPhone before, and here it stayed looking really good. And just from looking at it myself, it tended to be a bit cleaner and better than Guardians of the Galaxy. And I will say, and it makes sense, most of the time Microsoft does tend to optimize their first-party games over third-party. It's not to say that's the case every time. There are third-party games that run better than some of the first-party games, but things like Halo and Gears and Forza and those, especially Flight Simulator, seem to be getting a little bit better treatment when it comes to running really well on xCloud. And again, like I said, that makes sense. But Gears 5 was fantastic on my iPhone. Let's jump over to Halo. And when it comes to Halo, well, Halo Infinite ran very much like the iPad. Again, I think the picture quality might be a little better on the iPad, but this was great. Pixelation didn't really tend to kick in. Latency was absolutely fantastic with my backbone controller. Much more confidence going into battle or gameplay, and no disconnects, which I keep saying that because it's something I suffered so much before. Either a game wouldn't run at all, or it would disconnect, or it would be completely unplayable. So I was pleased to see Halo Infinite and other games running this well on the iPhone. Let's check out one more game, and that's Forza Horizon 5. And we'll just take a quick look at this game, because Forza Horizon 5 is a game that I really was wanting to be able to play on my iPhone and my iPad, and I only checked this out on iPhone. It was something I did at the end when I was wanting to check out another game, and I was pleasantly surprised. Now, this is on quality mode running at 30 FPS, but it runs even better on performance mode at 60, but the game's absolutely gorgeous. It does have some more pixelation than some of the other games, especially when you're moving this fast, but man, this was so much cleaner than what I had experienced before when I just absolutely couldn't play at all. I gotta say, the improvements that they have made to iPad and iPhone for gaming on Safari are definitely real, and you can definitely notice the difference. It's not to say this would be the case for every single game or every single person, but I'm very pleased to see what they've done here and the kind of improvements that we're getting. Hopefully they continue the good work at Microsoft for xCloud. All right, guys, thanks a lot for coming to check out the video as always. We really appreciate it, and we'll see you in the next one.